Hello, my name is Pam Drinnon, and I'm here today to teach you self-shiatsu, or self-acupressure, as many people call it. But before I begin, let me explain my background in shiatsu therapy. I have been a Shiatsu-Anma Therapist since 1984. I was certified at the Dow Center of the Healing Arts in Los Angeles, where I studied Chinese medicine and Japanese acupressure massage. I believe in the benefits of self-shiatsu because I myself experienced a great healing from it. In 1982, I started having a lot of pain and achiness in my joints, and my muscles hurt and felt sore all the time. I also had a bladder infection that would not clear up, and it just got worse. A year later, I was diagnosed with arthritis. My body was full of toxins. Even my lower back went out of alignment. I had a slipped disc. Unable to take the anti-inflammatory medicine, I decided to try other healing practices, chiropractor, acupuncture, shiatsu, a nutritionist, Chinese herbs, yoga, and a spiritual counselor. It took 2 years and a strong faith, but by changing my eating habits, exercise, yoga every day, and learning shiatsu, I was able to speed up my own healing process by working on myself. I have been free of arthritis pain since 1984. I believe we have the ability to heal ourselves if we will place ourselves in a healing state and focus on bringing our body back to harmony and balance. Before we continue, there are some key terms you need to be familiar with. The first is Tao. The Tao is both manifest and non-manifest. It produces heaven and earth, man and woman. It is a universal energy that eternally produces, permeates, and nourishes all. Next is Yin and Yang. Yin and Yang constitute the two opposing forces of infinity, contraction and expansion, positive and negative. Most people tend to be either yin or yang natured. Yang people are extroverts, yin people are introverts. Qi. Qi is the life force, a vital healing energy that flows through the body. Qi, or ki, as it's known in Japan, is the source of all life, and its undisturbed flow is the key to radiant health. Meridians. Qi flows through meridians, which are channels in the body. There are 12 meridians, and they are named after the organs they benefit. There's the heart meridian, heart constrictor, lung, bladder, gallbladder, stomach, large intestines, small intestines, kidney, spleen, and triple heater. The last term is Shen. The spirit in each person. Your body is the outward manifestation of your Shen. To see it, look into your eyes. If the Shen is weak, the eyes are dull and lifeless. Healthy Shen shows itself in clear, sparkling eyes. Now to begin our self-shiatsu. Find an open area on the floor. All you'll need is an ordinary tennis ball like this one. Get into a comfortable position. First, I'll explain where each meridian flows, and then I will show you where to work on it. The bladder meridian begins on the inside corners of the eyes, travels over the head, down each side of the spine, and onto the legs, ending at the little toes. The bladder meridian's main function is elimination. Weakness in the bladder meridian can cause the entire body to feel fatigued. One may experience pain down the back, sciatica, and or lower back problems. The bladder meridian is also associated with headaches and a stiff neck. Remember that each meridian is like a river of energy that originates at a point in the body and flows downward or upward to another point. Meridians channel life force, or chi, to every cell in the body. When the river is blocked, chi is prevented from getting to an area of the body, resulting in pain, swelling, or discomfort. First, we'll be working the bladder meridian. Now, we'll be taking a tennis ball, and we'll show you how to do this in a moment. But I want you to roll the ball down the spine. Not on the spine, but right next to it is where the meridian flows. All the way down to the very tip of the tailbone. From here to here are pressure points that go to all the meridians. It's a very important area to work. Taking the tennis ball, when we get into the buttock area, this is where we have lower back pain, sciatica pain. I'll show you how to work that when we get there. Then coming up to the other side, I want you to roll the ball down. Again, remember this bladder meridian flows down both sides of the back, all the way down. Now when you do this, just move the ball about a half an inch or an inch at a time. You'll see how I do it in a moment. Just keep moving the ball, and when you feel some sore spots, lay on that spot for a moment, even 30 seconds or a minute, whatever would feel good to you. Just keep working that. Now if it's real sore, move the ball away from that area and then come back to it. Now, again, down into the buttock area. In here is sciatica pain, pressure points. Really good for this. Thank you, Laverne. Okay, now take your tennis ball and lay down, keeping your knees up. We're going to roll on the tennis ball. Bring your left arm up and just let it drop back. That way you can really get some good pressure in there. I'm going to be moving the ball down a little bit at a time. Just kind of moving on the ball and rolling my shoulder around. If it's too painful with your arm up, let your arm drop. It's all right. If you can handle the pressure, get in there and work that good area between the shoulder blades. Keep moving the ball down. Now I'm going to be doing this a little bit faster than I would have to at home. Maybe if you feel a sore area, you can lay on that area for a minute. Don't lay on the spine. Just fall right next to the spine. Just kind of rock into it, roll in. It really feels good. Or just lay on it. Just relax. Just keep moving the ball. Lift your buttocks up a little bit, put some good pressure in there. I mean, these are important pressure points that you're working on. Stimulate the organs. And get into the waist area so you'll get a good pressure. Lift up the buttock and push into it. And all the way down. All the way down to the very tip of the tailbone. Then you get to the tailbone and once you take the ball, you're going to roll around on the ball. You can just let your leg just fall down. Just like that. Good pressure in there. All around. real good for lower back pain, sciatica pain. Work this area. I'm bringing the ball up to the other side. Push it down far enough. You can lay back on it. And take some deep breaths. As you exhale, push in with the ball. Again, bring your arm up. Keep moving the ball down. A little bit at a time. Feels really good. Really moves the tension out of the body. Take a little working with the ball and maneuvering to get it just how you want. Just make sure it's right next to the spine. Sore spot? Get in that sore spot. Really roll it. Feels good. We'll work the soreness. Get it right out of the body. That tension. Get in the area where you need more pressure. Let's move back to the body. Good pressure on it. And just lay on it. Get down to the bed again. Lift up your leg all over. Good pressure. To the hip. Feels really good. Get tension on the body. Do that several times. And after you've done both sides, you just sit up. The ball, put it in the very center of the leg. Might look to keep this leg up. Or let it fall over, whichever feels good to you. Just move that ball a little bit at a time. Put some pressure on it. Feels good. Bottom meridian goes straight down the back of the leg. When you get to the knee, it's a good area. Kind of roll that ball around. Put some pressure in there. That's a pressure point. That's for lower back pain behind the knees, too. Keep moving the ball. You can even roll on the ball a little bit. Then you want to do the other leg. Remember, keep the ball in the center of the leg. Press. Some good pressure on that. It helps stretch out the hamstring too. And get to the knee. Roll around a little bit. Back of the knee. All the way down. Okay. And that's the end of the bladder meridian. The spleen meridian runs outside the big toe, along the shin bone to the knee, and up the inside of the thigh to the stomach. It mainly influences reproduction and digestion. Sensitivity along this meridian indicates menstrual pain, excessive belching and flatulence, plus a nervous stomach. Now I'm going to show you where to work on the spleen meridian. The spleen meridian is located along the top inner edge of both legs. Taking your thumb, you start massaging this area, going in deeply. Just make sure you're not in the center of the leg. You want to be on the top edge of the leg. See how that goes right down the leg, right up against that bone, all the way down to the foot, to the toes. You can take your elbow and press there. You want to get better pressure, deeper pressure. Feels really good. Just taking your hands, just work down right along the knee, right along inside the leg, all the way down to the toes. Work this side with two. Probably feel a little bit more sensitive around the knees. There are more pressure points at the knees and also at the ankles. So it'll always feel a little bit more sensitive in this area. Keep massaging this area till it doesn't feel sore to you anymore. All the way down to the top of the feet. That's the spleen meridian. The liver meridian runs upward from the big toe along the inner part of the calf and thigh to the abdomen. It relates to the storage of nutrients and energy. Soreness along this meridian may indicate knee and joint pain, irregular menstruation, and sexual dysfunctions. Now I'm going to show you where to work on the liver meridian. The liver meridian is in the very center of the leg and it goes all the way down to the toes. Taking both thumbs, rotate, keep your hands right in the very center of the leg and just massage down the leg, press. It feels a little sore in there, keep working that area. Some good deep pressure in there. Probably feel pretty sensitive inside the leg. It does on most people. Remember that it'll be sensitive around the ankles. It's a good area to work and massage. I'm going to do both sides. Find the very center of the leg inside. Press. Feels really good. One side will probably feel more sensitive than the other side. One leg more sensitive. You can use both thumbs. Again, you could use your elbows. If you want to get your thumbs get tired, you want to get some good pressure in there with your elbows. It feels really good too to do it that way. Coming down the leg. Make sure you stay in the center of the leg. You'll be able to tell when you're on the meridian because it'll feel real sensitive to you. You'll feel it. Keep working those areas when they're sore. Keep going over and over. All the way down top of the feet. The kidney meridian runs along the bottom of the foot, up the inside of the leg, to the sex organs. The kidneys cleanse the blood of impurities and helps eliminate waste. Sensitivity along this meridian may indicate lower back pain, insomnia, and ringing in the ears, also loss of hair. Now we're going to work with the kidney meridian. The kidney meridian is located on the very center edge of the leg, right down through here. Taking your hands, you can grasp and roll and press along this meridian all the way down to the ankle. You can use your thumb to work the tension out. If you feel any soreness, be sure and keep working over and over that meridian. And again, the meridian is in this leg too. So starting along this edge, which is right next to the bladder meridian, and just work your way up. If you feel any stiffness or any soreness in there, just keep pressing. Get the chi to flow. Chi will take the pain and the soreness out of that area. And then, to stretch all six meridians, just get up on your knees, your toes. All the meridians run down to the very tip of the toes. So this is just a real good stretch. Just sitting like this energizes all the meridians in the legs. That's the bladder and the kidneys and the liver, the spleen, the stomach, and the gallbladder. The gallbladder meridian runs from the temple around the outside of the ear, downward to the outside of the leg, and ending at the fourth toe. This meridian is concerned with the distribution of energy and is associated with headaches, including migraines, pain in the joints, and hyperacidity in the stomach. Now I'm going to show you where to work on the gallbladder meridian. The gallbladder meridian is located in the very center of the leg, very like the seam of the pant leg would be there. You're going to work there. Now taking your hands from both sides of the leg and just press or rotate, even using your fingers, whatever you feels comfortable to you, just keep working that. Come down to the knees, stay in the center of the leg, so you'll be on the meridian, gets the chi to flow, and come all the way down to the top of the feet. Pressing deeply, feels really good. Just keep the center of the leg. You'll feel that meridian when you're on it. Be sensitive. And the gallbladder finishes the tip of the toes. The stomach meridian runs downward along the thigh and calf to a point at the top of the second toe. The stomach meridian is concerned with one's appetite and intake of food. Sensitivity along this meridian can indicate a lack of appetite associated with worry and gastric problems, such as constipation and diarrhea. Now we're going to work on the stomach meridian. The stomach meridian is located right here on the leg, right up next to this bone. So start massaging this area. You can use your thumbs one at a time. The meridian is on both sides of the leg, so you can work just like this, down to the knees, all the way down. Watch where my thumbs are. All the way down, right in here, this is stomach 36. Good pressure point to get the chi flowing. Come all the way down to your ankles, to your feet, up to the tip of the toes. You can grasp, roll, squeeze that meridian. Sometimes if your legs are strong, you want to work deep. Bringing your thumbs up. So you can see exactly where I'm putting my hands. And I work both sides of the legs. Very important to do both sides. All the way up to the top. You can work a lot slower than I am. Just take your time. You feel sensitive areas, stay on those areas. As long as you want to, just massage it. Work those areas. It feels good. All the way up. And you can finish here. The small intestine's meridian runs from the little finger and up the outside of the arm. The small intestine is concerned with assimilation of nutrients. Soreness along this meridian may indicate headache, pain and stiffness in the neck, and aching in the shoulders. The triple-heater meridian runs from the top of the fourth finger and up the arm to the shoulder. The triple heater provides chi to the small intestines and the lymphatic system, plus assists in circulation. Soreness along this meridian may indicate headaches, sore throat, fever, stiff neck, and the common cold. The large intestine's meridian runs from the tip of the index finger and up the arm to the neck. This meridian is associated with elimination and breathing. Sensitivity along it may indicate constipation that may shift to diarrhea, headaches, nasal congestion, and symptoms of the common cold. Now we're going to work with the meridians in the arms. The first meridian we'll work with is the small intestine's meridian, which is located on the very outer edge of the arm. Coming like this, what you'll do is just grasp and roll the arm towards you. Just lift the arm up. Now I'm going to be doing this a lot faster than you will. I want you to take your time and work these meridians. When you get around the elbows and again the wrist, it'll be a lot more sensitive because there's more pressure points there. Working all the way out to the tip of the finger. We'll work both arms, lifting and rolling the outer edge of the arm all the way down to the little finger. You can use your thumb and work. You can use all fingers. Work up the arm. Then the next meridian is the triple heater. And it flows from the middle finger up, all the way up the arm, to the very top of the shoulder. Just starting there, again, just a rotating with your fingers. Go on that several times. Feels really good. Taking your thumb, work down the arm, all the way down to the middle finger. The same on this arm too. Stay in the very center of the arm to work with the triple heater. Kind of a rotating, pressing, massaging. You can just press. Just take your time. Just work in the areas. When it feels sore and sensitive, just keep working the area all the way down to the middle finger. The next meridian is the large intestine meridian, which flows from this point in the hand. Large intestine 4, it's a real potent point to massage and to work. Bring your arm up, all the way up. The meridian comes up through here. So I just take my thumb, and I just massage on the, this is the top edge of the arm, the front part of the arm. Same on this side. Make sure you stay on the top edge. Get in there and work deep. Feel a little sensation when you get around the elbows and the wrist. Work right in here, large intestine 4. Massage that area a lot.
The lung meridian runs from a point just above the clavicle along the inside of the arm to the thumb. The lung meridian relates to the storage of nutrients and energy. Sensitivity along this meridian may indicate susceptibility to colds, lack of stamina, extreme fatigue, difficulty in breathing. The heart constrictor meridian runs from the armpit down the middle of the arm to the tip of the middle finger. The function of the heart constrictor meridian is to assist the heartbeat and circulation. Sensitivity along this meridian may indicate discomfort and even pain in the chest and ribcage, dizziness and poor circulation, and also tightness in the hands. The heart meridian runs from the armpit along the inside of the arm to the point of the little finger. The function of the heart meridian is circulation and the distribution of qi. Soreness in the heart meridian may indicate mental fatigue, memory loss, shoulder and arm pain, nervous stomach, and palpitations.
Remember, there are 3 meridians on the insides of the arm. The first meridian we'll be working with is the lung meridian. It's massaging the top. Grasping, rolling. Stay on the inside edge of the arm using your thumb. Work all the way down to the wrist. And here is lung 7. Again, a potent point, a good area to work. Doing both arms. This goes really good. Work deep. Some good deep pressure in the arms. Again, on this side, lung 7. The center of the arm is where the heart constrictor, or the pericardium, is located. So starting right at the center, the top of the arm, work your way down. Using your thumb and your fingers. Be sensitive around the elbow and the wrist area again. Work both arms. All the way down to the wrist. Keep going over it, filling sore spots. And on the inside edge is the heart meridian. So just take your hand and just squeeze it, press all the way down, stay on top edge of the arm, working it. It's really good. Working this arm too. You stay on the edge, the arm, inside edge. You feel a little sensation when you get close to the elbows, where there are more pressure points there. That's the meridians on the insides of the arm. We're going to work with the neck, meridians in the neck, and they are the small intestines, the large intestines, and the triple heater. They flow from the arm all the way up into the neck. So just gently massage the neck, working from the top down to the bottom up, grasping, squeezing, rolling. Feels really good. Should we work these meridians? Now there are pressure points at the very base of the, along the skull. They're real good for headaches. So press right up against the skull. That feels real good in the very back. That area. Now to work the pressure points in the head, there are bladder meridians and gallbladder and triple heater. So gently tapping the head, keeping a loose fist, to start right around the ears. That's the triple heater. And then along the top of the head, just gently tapping, making a loose, soft fist. You might feel some sore spots when you do this. It feels good. The chi flowing in the head. Then, when we want to work the face, there are pressure points for the sinuses, and they're called stomach points and large intestines points. So taking your thumbs, press right up against the cheekbone, all the way around, come up the head, working in the sinus area, down between the nose. Feel some soreness in this area. It's a good area to work. For your sinuses, you can just keep going over it and over it if you have problems with them. And then, grasping and squeezing along the chin. That's very good. And gently press the eyes several times. Now I'm going to show you how to work on the stomach, and it's also called the hara. So what I want you to do is just to lay down flat, the first thing you'll be doing is called a soothing motion, and it's done in a clockwise way. Bring your right hand over and the left hand over, calming, relaxing the stomach. It's very important to always work on your stomach in the morning or in the evenings. If you only have time to work one area, work on your stomach. So after 9 or 10 circular movements to relax and calm the stomach. You will start up in the very top in the solar plexus area. Both let the fingers touch, taking a deep breath. And as you exhale, you're going to press down as deep as you can. Press in. Now we're going to do a straight line all the way down to here. So take a deep breath again. And as you exhale, press in. Hold for a second. Again. Just keep moving down the stomach. Feels a little tightness. Press as deep as you can. This is to relax. Get the tension out of the stomach. We carry a lot of tension in our stomach. Now remember, we're working in a clockwise motion. We're going to be coming up the right side, placing your right fingers down, left on top. Take a deep breath and just press in very deeply. We're going to move the chi. Moving our hands along the colon area. Now you might feel a little sensitiveness up in this area. That's the gallbladder and the liver area. Coming right across the top of the stomach. Be sure and exhale when you press in. Allows you to go really deep. Coming down along the colon. Fingers on top of each other. It feels tight. Go over that area several times. All the way down. You could do this at least three times, working around the stomach as you inhale and exhale. The last thing you do is taking your right hand and lay it across the navel, your left hand on top, and you're going to do a little vibration, a little shaking movement. But press down right on the navel, press deeply as you can, you shake it and vibrate it, take a deep breath, and as you exhale, press in as far as you can and hold it for the count of three, and then release. Is working with the stomach. That's the end of our Self-Shiatsu workout. As you can see, the exercises I have shown you are not difficult or taxing. People of all ages can do them and receive benefits from them. If possible, do the entire workout at least three times a week, and at best every day. You will right away feel less pain and tension and an increase in energy. You will also notice a sense of well-being. Be sure to drink plenty of water after each workout. This helps flush the toxins out of the body. I'm sure you will benefit greatly from this method of healing that has worked so well for me and the many people I've worked with and trained. Self-Shiatsu is surprisingly simple, yet remarkably effective. It is a powerful healing method, and I am honored to present it to you on your journey to better health and well-being. Gosho.